Hello, welcome to Saws UK. My name is Alan Peakfield. This is our model HD400LR-H. It's a bandsaw with a cast iron bow, very, very solid bow this. It will take all the vibration out of the cut. Very handy when you're cutting horrible materials like stainless steel. It actually deadens all the noise, not to mention the fact that it's extremely strong and won't move around. The guides for the blade are made of carbide, which are hidden in here. They're also backed up with ball bearings, so the blade will slide through the ball bearings first and then through the carbide tips here and here. Obviously, copious amounts of coolant goes through these pipes here, lubricating the workpiece. Very large hydraulic cylinder here and a 3 kW motor to drive the blade. On the rear of the machine, we have adjustment for the bow weight. We can reduce the weight of the bow bearing down on the work. So if we're cutting thin wall sections, we're not putting too much weight on the work, and also we can have increased weight for cutting stainless steel, for instance, where you need the penetration. Obviously the machine comes down by a hydraulic cylinder as slow as you like, but the head weight is also a crucial point in the way the machine cuts. Down here we have an adjustable unit, which means that you can set the blade so it just comes clear of the workpiece, so repetition, you're not wasting time, it's just coming clear of the job, and then you can switch it on again and it goes down and does the cut. Naturally, as it's a semi-automatic cut, it goes down to do the cut, then comes up to your predetermined height governed by this. On this machine we have a length stop, which is graduated here up to 600 mm, and it has a nifty device on the end which means that when you're cutting, when you finish cutting, you just move the handle like that, which then relieves the workpiece. It stops it getting trapped between the stop and the blade, like this. Down here, behind this door, you have the hydraulic pack, easy access for maintenance and topping up. Behind it is the coolant pump and a removable tank, so you can clean that out every few months as you wish. Right, mitering. The bow will swivel to 60 degrees in this direction, that's past 45 to 60 degrees. In the other direction, it goes to 45 degrees. As you can see, it's a bow that swivels, the vices stay where they are, so your work is always going down the same plane through the workshop, you haven't got it sticking out all over the place. The vice goes from left to right, so you can move the vice to the right when you're doing the left mitre. As you can see, the bow just comes around like that. Right, the controls of the machine. Obviously the vise is adjusted with a handle here. You have a quick lock lever, so if you've got repetition, you can just use the lever to clamp the work. Over here, you have the stop switch, the emergency stop switch, and the start switches. The machine has separate coolant supply on an electric pump. The speed of the machine is governed here with a frequency inverter, so you can be doing aluminium right down to stainless steel or even harder with this adjustment here. The downfeed of the machine, that's the rate of descent of the bow, is governed by this. And as I mentioned earlier, you can actually adjust the weight of that on the back of the machine, on the handle, on the springs. You would have two modes of operating the machine. One of them is where you press the start button and the machine will go down and stop at the bottom, or you can have it so when you press the start button it goes down to the bottom and pops back up to a predetermined height that you set on the back of the machine. I mentioned that earlier as well. This machine uses a 34 mm blade as opposed to 27. With a 34 mm wide blade you can cut much thicker materials, much harder materials, stronger materials, etc. The adjustment of the blade, the tensioning of the blade is done here. It will actually bottom out when it's reached the right tension. That's because there are a set of bell wheel spring washers in there which provide the tension, and obviously they collapse, and when they've completely collapsed you can't turn the handle anymore. So it's right every time. The tension is correct every time you do it up. Should the blade break or come off, there's a switch here that will make the machine switch off. As you can see, there is a laser line passed across the workpiece. It's an option on the machine should you wish to work to a line that you've already scribed onto your workpiece. Also as an option is our vegetable oil spray. It means that tiny bits of vegetable oil will arrive on the blade and you won't end up with coolant all over the floor. Obviously the flood system is the normal system on the machine, but the vegetable oil works very well when you're cutting tubes, box section, etc. So we'll do a cut now.